So every year, you get asked from all sides, your work, your pharmacy, your school, and even at your doctor's office, have you gotten your flu shot? Well, in this video, we're going to talk to you about what that flu is and why you should care about getting it. Also, make sure you stick around to the end, and I'll share with you another tip that can help you save money on your healthcare. Welcome to Family Med, your medical home for practical and accurate information to help your family make healthy decisions. I'm Dr. Eric Richardson. My passion is helping you cut through all the health information clutter on the internet. If that sounds like the kind of information you or your family needs, make sure you follow along with us. Hit that subscribe button and share it with your friends. So what is a flu? There's still a lot of confusion on what we are talking about when we use the word flu. A lot of times when people talk about the flu, they're thinking about the stomach virus that sends you to the toilet with vomiting and diarrhea. That's actually something we call gastroenteritis, or what most will call it, the stomach flu. Now, what we're talking about today is influenza. This is a respiratory illness caused by the influenza virus that affects mostly the respiratory tract. This is more than your common cold. This is a serious illness that at times can lead to death. In the 2017-2018 season, there were approximately 49 million people with a flu illness, 960,000 hospitalizations, 79,000 deaths, 185 children died, and 80% of those were not immunized. To put even more context into it, 2018 is the 100-year anniversary of the 1918 influenza pandemic. That year, 675,000 people in the United States died, and over 50 million people worldwide died. That is a staggering number, which I don't think our modern time we can even comprehend. But this is real. This disease is real. So what are the symptoms, and how do you know you have it? In actuality, the only way you know for sure is to get tested at your doctor's office. But there are certain signs that point to it being more likely. Now, the flu usually comes on suddenly. People who have the flu oftentimes feel some or all of these symptoms. These would be a high fever, cough, sore throat, runny or stuffy nose, body aches, headaches, chills, fatigue, and sometimes actually diarrhea and vomiting, but not very often. They sound a lot like a regular cold symptom, don't they? Check out this figure from the CDC where it spells out the difference. I'll also put some of this in the notes below so you can reference it. But the main difference we tend to see with a flu is really the quickness in which it comes on, as well as the severity in which it hits. The classic presentation that I'll see in my clinic is that patient who is lying on the exam table, coughing their lungs out, with a high fever and shaking chills and body aches. It's more than just the sniffles. So why is it important that you know the difference? Well, of course it's important to know so you can know what to expect from your illness. But it's also important to know because fortunately with influenza, there are some treatments available that can potentially help decrease the severity of symptoms, as well as decrease the length of your illness. If you have symptoms that are consistent with influenza, and if it's caught within the first 24 to 48 hours, then there are some treatments that are available through your doctor. The most common one that you may hear about is oseltamivir or Tamiflu. This one's been around for a while and can be helpful to decrease the time of illness and severity of symptoms. In studies, it's been found to decrease the time of illness by about a day. There's a brand new one called baloxavir or Xofluza. This was just approved for use in October of 2018, so we haven't had the chance to see this one in day-to-day practice. But this is a once-a-day dosing that seems to have showed that it does work better than Tamiflu in the one study that got them approved through the FDA. So since this is so new though, we really have to see how this plays out over time. Not everybody will likely get the medication, nor should they. If you go to your doctor, however, those who especially may benefit are people who are in nursing homes, those who are over 65, those with chronic conditions such as asthma, COPD, diabetes, liver disease, cancers, kidney failure, as well as those who are very obese. Now, those with severe symptoms can also benefit from it. So get to your doctor and talk to them about your options. But unfortunately, for true influenza, other than the prescription medications that we listed, there isn't much you can do to treat it other than the medications that help with symptoms. Prevention really is the key when it comes to influenza. For a good discussion on the best steps that you can take to prevent from getting sick, check out my video on how to keep from getting sick. The other way to prevent, of course, is getting our flu shot. We're going to dive into this a little bit deeper on a future video. But the fact of the matter is that by getting your flu shot, you're less likely to get the flu. If you do get the flu, you're less likely to be admitted to the hospital for it. If you're admitted to the hospital, you're less likely to be in the ICU, and you're less likely to die from it. So the fact of the matter is, the flu shot is the best chance you have of avoiding it. So I hope you've been able to gain a little bit better appreciation of what influenza is and why it's so important that we try to prevent it. I hope that you found this information to be useful. If so, make sure you take the time to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and even hit that notification button so you don't miss out on any of our new content. Doing so really helps me to be able to continue to produce useful content like this. Remember, my purpose in sharing this information for you is to educate you in things that you can think about in trying to make decisions in your own health. In no way should it be taken as direct medical advice to you in your own situation. Please consult your own doctor for concerns regarding your specific situation. Okay, so for those of you stuck around till the end, here's your bonus tip on how to save money on your health care. One of the most expensive places to have care done is in the hospital. If you're going in for an elective surgery, pick a surgeon who does operations as an independent outpatient surgery center. Not all surgeries are appropriate to be done there, but many are. You can save as much as half on the cost of your surgery by doing so. So that's all I have for today. Again, make sure you hit that subscribe button and check out the other videos on our site. So until next time, this is Family Med with Dr. Eric Richardson. Remember, please take care of your body because it's the only one you have.